in the last year. And I am with Alfredo Parisi, part of the Libre Umbria's working group. Who is Libre Italia? The first question. Libre Italia is a voluntary Italian association founded by the Italian community of LibreOffice, which arose from Libre Italia's Google Plus community. Libre Italia is made up of developers, trainers, teachers, ICT professionals, civil servants, but also domestic users, ordinary users, who wants to share solutions and problems about LibreOffice and about open source in general, and about also by open data and open government. The 23 founders are ICT professionals and civil servants with a valuable experience of migration. Valuable experience of migration from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice. Many of the founders are members of the Document Foundation and therefore already actively engaged in the LibreOffice project. Almost all of the members of the Board of Directors of Libre Italia are present here in Berlin at the LibreOffice conference. Marina Latini, our Vice President and Technical Manager, Alfredo Parisi, who spoke about the Libre Umbria project, and our Honorary President, Italo Vignoli. The other members of the board who can't be with us today are Andrea Castellani, Giordano Borghetti, and Gabriele Ponzo. Libre Italia's community on Google Plus has almost 2,400 active members that every day share news, information, problems and solutions about LibreOffice and about open source in general. The community is very important for professional and domestic users who are looking for solutions to specific problems. And many members of the community follow discussions and quickly provide responses to the requests for help from users. In addition, the community also provides an important meeting point for people to build new professional networks. Libre Italia is also very social. We have a Twitter account, a Facebook page, and more recently a YouTube channel and a SlideShare profile that help us to introduce our activities and our project. Our blog, libreitalia.it, plays an important communication role. In the blog, we publish every week news about the LibreOffice project, but also documents, spreadsheets, presentations, models developed by the members of the community who want to share their work with others. For example, last month we published a spreadsheet with a budget template developed by a member of the Libre Italia community. We also publish interviews with ICT professionals who, in business or in public administrations, have ended the migration from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice in order to provide success stories to emulate. And finally, in the blog, we publish news about events organized by our community and by other open source community in Italy. And Okay, and the question what we have done? We have a wealth of valuable experiences at Libre Italia. The first one, Libre Umbria, Libre Umbria, the migration project of Umbria's regional government administration that has involved about 5,000 desktops and similar projects in the provinces of Bolzano, Macerata, Cremona, and Milan, and in the municipalities of Terni, Viterbo, and Turin, more recently in Turin. Another significant project has involved the desktops of one of Italy's major trade of union, CISL, named CISL. And another important project is Libre Veneto. Libre Veneto deals with the regional public health organization, where about 500 desktops have been migrated, and another 1,000 are planned for the next year. The total number of workstations migrated so far in Italy is about 16,000. Libre Italia wants to support the digital culture and the culture of free and open source software through seminars, courses, and training sessions. For example, in August, we organized, in association with Umbrian Linux User Group, the Linux Summer. The event consists of 5 free access seminars on Linux and LibreOffice and open source internet browsers and email software. And Libre Italia wants to spread the best practice of migration through national contests. For example, the national contest organized by Formans in Italy and aimed at the individualization of experience, which formed the national guidelines for digital culture and skills, which now contains Libre Umbria's model of teaching in public administration. And what we will do: promote LibreOffice and open source, obviously. Libre Italia wishes to facilitate the development, dissemination, and promotion of the LibreOffice suite and the open source software to reduce the digital divide and to break down the barriers of information and technology for the people who are less able to access opportunities. Develop digital culture and skills. Libre Italia wants to promote digital culture to provide all citizens equal access to technology and equal opportunities of participation to the knowledge society. And spread free software in public administrations and schools. Libre Italia will contribute to spreading open source software in public administration, especially in schools and universities, to support the growth of digital culture and the value of collaboration by young people. Promote open document format. Libre Italia will promote the spreading of open formats, like Open Document Format, ODF, to allow the interoperability and therefore to guarantee permanent access to the data and information, especially in public administration. Support open data usage. We wish to promote the dissemination of open data and free and universal access to resources and information. We think that the monopoly of ideas is to limit the cultural development of everyone. Encourage digital new enterprises. Libre Italia wants to encourage the birth of new enterprises who can develop new solutions for open source software and provide job opportunities for young people. What we'd like to organize? We'd like to organize courses also in e-learning for LibreOffice developers in order to increase the number of ICT professionals in the Italian community and therefore in the LibreOffice project. An Italian conference. In the coming months we will organize the first Italian LibreOffice conference in order to promote the activities and the project of LibreItalia. Support ECDL open source. We'll create a working group who will support the development and dissemination of European computer driving license with open source software, in particular with LibreOffice. And developing an e-learning platform for LibreOffice courses. LibreItalia wishes to develop an e-learning platform to put free LibreOffice courses online. We should complete and grow the prototype of LibreUmbria's project named LibreCampus and realize in recent months with Moodle and WordPress. How we get organized? LibreItalia wants to constitute a committee of experts in open government and open source that will help us to identify the project and the activities of the association. And we will create some working groups with a team leader who can coordinate the work of the volunteers. And the members of LibreItalia will keep in touch by video conference and also by meetings in different Italian cities. We think in October we will organize the first meeting in the city of Perugia, in the center of Italy. The answer when, after 3 years of living as an online community, LibreItalia was born in August as an organization. In August this year, and the necessary paperwork for recognition as a non-profit organization has just been submitted, but our founders began to define our goals and activities sometime before that. We are organizing a lot of things in the next few months, and most of which I've already mentioned in this presentation, and I tell you, follow us if you want. Where are we? LibreItalia's headquarters are in the city of Perugia, in the center of Italy. The choice of location is linked to the LibreUmbria project, which gave a boost to many of the activities that we intend to organize as an association. But apart from this, Perugia is geographically at the center of the Italy, so easy to reach for those who live in the north than in the south. And the last question, why LibreItalia? The first reason is for free software in public administration. The spread of open source software in Italy, in public administration, is patchy. There are some best practices. practice to follow, like Libre Umbria and Libre Veneto, but there is still much to do, especially in public administration, where it is necessary to present the opportunities of the open source software, where it is too often unknown. Libre Italia has calculated that the Italian public administration could gain 600 million euro adopting LibreOffice. And we all know that this is not the only reason why public administrations should choose open source software. Free software in schools. Libre Italia can support initiatives aimed to increase the use of open source software in schools and in the universities, as shown the Libre Umbria School Project. Most schools have only experienced proprietary software. With Libre Umbria School Project, we organized seminars aimed to teachers and parents to educate them on how technological choices impact the sharing of knowledge. We also provide courses that show how schools how to switch the PCs in open source software. Free software to support digital culture. In Italy, according to a recent European Commission research, 60% of Italians don't have digital skills necessary to do their jobs. And it's no better for our digital natives, who, according to UKids Online research, are second last for digital skills. The adoption of free software, according to the model that we will propose, that focuses on training, develops skills, and goes to fill many of the gaps which people have. Open format in public administration. The Microsoft proprietary format doc, unfortunately, is considered the standard for many public administrations. If we consider the value of information and data, we understand that this is an absurdity. So Libre Italia wants to support the spread of open formats like ODF and apply pressure so that they can be adopted by all the Italian public administrations, as has already happened in the UK. All the activities that we will do will focus on the growth of the Italian community and therefore the LibreOffice project. Here there are our contacts. You can contact us by email, or you can follow us on social media, on Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus, and Slash Share, and Flickr. You can read and follow our blog, libreitalia.it. And thank you. Thanks to Italo Mignoli. Libre Italia owes its success to him.
It's not true. They are being well paid.
Thanks for your attention, and thanks to the organizers of LibreOffice Conference for hosting us today. Thank you very much.
I'm here to answer. luckily everyone in the project knows me, so you know how.
Fine. How many of the migrations or the administrations have support, professional support for LibreOffice? Do all of them have it, or some?
Public administration, some public administrations have ended the migration in-house.
Yes.
But many public administrations don't have the professionals in-house to do the migration, and so they need the help from enterprise, from business enterprise.
And is it also support for bug fixing sometimes, or just for the migration process itself?
It's more a general process. The bug fixing needs education, so people they don't understand that. They're, let's say, in this sense, they are uneducated by Microsoft. The fact that if you find a bug in Microsoft Office, there's no chance to get the bug solved. So they don't even think that they can get the bug solved in LibreOffice. So now we are at the stage that we are educating people and tell people it's important that you find the bug, because if you find the bug, someone can put attention on the bug. And if the bug is really nasty for you, you can pay someone that solves the bug.
Yeah.
But it's yet, you know, people look
you
at you.
Like
yeah, people look at you and say, but are you serious about that? I say, yes, I'm serious. The code is there, so you can solve the problem.
Yeah.
But then the software is going to work. Yes, of course, it's going to work.
Okay.
The
yeah, when good certified migration. People in Italy, all the deployments in the end will understand.
Yeah, you know, the process is a long one. It's not happening tomorrow. Unfortunately, it's not happening tomorrow.
No, it's not happening tomorrow.
I didn't
mention
the amount of money you save in public administration. 600 million.
So it's a projection. So they in the. The Umbria project, they've analyzed in a very deep way the savings on the first 1,000 users. So they really, there is a spreadsheet which is in Italian but it's published. So it's you can look at all the costs that have been involved in migrating to LibreOffice compared to all the costs that would have been involved in updating to Microsoft Office. So on the first 1,000 users, they saved 220,000 euros. So if you project the number of employees of the public administration in Italy, which is almost 4 million, if you project those 200,000, it becomes 600 million. This is pure marketing and was my idea, but you have to do that. Otherwise, if you say we save $200,000, people would tell you it's peanuts. Say we say 600 million,
okay, so
then it's. But we have, you know, my idea could say we save 6 billion. I would have told 6 billion. Because you have to give figures that people, they mind blowing, you know, otherwise no one is going to listen to you.
Anyway, at least you can sell 6,000 desktops, right? 6,000 desktops?
Yes.
Times
yeah, exactly.
Microsoft license, at least.
Yeah, but the reality, their analysis is very complete because they've put all the costs.
Okay.
So training costs, even they've put on the cost of migrating to LibreOffice, even the press conference, which is not a migration cost, just because knowing our chickens, which are Microsoft guys in this case. If you put everything in the spreadsheet, then they cannot tell as they usually do. You know, It's because you've not considered everything that then your calculation is more positive than the other. So we have considered everything, even the time that people was going to smoke cigarettes outside, everything was there.
Even the cost of the ICT professionals in-house, where the migration...
So it's a really fair comparison. And what is amazing is that it has been presented to a general public administration body with Microsoft guys present, and the Microsoft guy who said could not comment the spreadsheet.
Okay, may I have more questions about the dashboard?
No, but I think it's important because it's a data that everyone, actually, I have the spread, a summary of the spreadsheet. So if people is interested, because that is official, so it's in an official document of the one Italian public administration has been registered. So it's a document that cannot be changed.
It's published on the blog of the
exactly. But you know, it is as a protocol has been recognized. Politicians have acknowledged that. So it's not something that you know I've just got it because I have a friend there. It's an official document. So and of course you have to reference to the Italian original because that is the only the English one is just a translation, but it's not the original document. But it's just a translation of an Italian original. And I think that this is important because gives a reference that no one can discuss. I mean, if you start discussing this, it's really you know you're going really after the smoke because that is really considering everything.
Resources that support digital culture,
yes,
which type of software?
Or in general, open source. The browser is Mozilla, Email Thunderbird, so we GIMP for...
Nothing special like preserve buildings?
No, it's really basics. So it's digital. When you have to teach the digital culture, unfortunately, you have to go to the basics. People, it's really... they lack culture, unfortunately. This is the reality. Doesn't mean that we, as an association, like TDF, we cannot charge for anything. Of course, it depends from the size of the project. If the project is too big, we might ask that the organization pays some money to the professional giving the courses, of course.
Okay, I'm asking because we have Well, in part, we did something similar, and we were told that if free of charge, it has no value. But you can maybe pay €5, but you have to do something, otherwise, free of charge has no value.
It depends from the environment. It depends from the environment. It actually. In their case, the courses were free of charge, but they were sponsored by the region, so that makes them official in a sense. Of course, it depends from the mentality of people. There are many variables, of course.
So one answer was, okay, your course is good, but next month I